8 lessons online. All right, we're back with our second part of our math content series. All right, we're going to be looking at this next part on statistics. All right, for my math content series as of now, okay, I'm going to be looking more at your statistics chapters. All right, since I've been covering a lot of your kind of like pure math or algebra based content through my questions that I've been going through in the past year level papers. So for this part, I want to start with stats, okay, because I know a lot of our J2s now are going through statistics. Okay, I know a lot of you guys may be struggling in stats, right? Stats, it can be a bit tricky at times, but it's a very clear, okay, very easy to do once you actually get it. All right, so this content series, okay, I hope that it will help you guys to clear up some doubts if you have any. And we're just going to be doing what the basic, okay, content is all about, okay, what you need to know, what you need to be looking out for, okay, and then subsequently anything else, you will need to make sure that you practice questions to actually understand how to do such questions, right? So in this video, we're going to be looking at probability. In the previous part, I've looked at permutations and combinations, right? I'll leave a link in the top right-hand corner of the screen as well as in the description below. Go and check out what PNC is all about. Okay, PNC is very important. It's crucial, okay, when it comes to your stats. Okay, these are the two main topics that I feel are the most challenging, okay, because there is just a whole myriad of different types of questions that can possibly come out. So you need to know what the basics really are. And in this video, I'm going to look at what, in this case, probability is all about. All right, so probability, the first thing you need to know is that for your A-levels, you need to know what kind of events you're looking at. Okay, so in probability, we are going to be looking at certain events. So it will look something like this. So you have got events. And it's kind of like the top. Okay, and then for events, you have got one type, whereby they are actually mutually exclusive. Okay, so on one hand, you have got events which are mutually exclusive. On the other hand, it's when they are not mutually exclusive. Okay, and under when the case, if they are not mutually exclusive, they are either going to be independent events or they are not independent. Alright, so this is kind of like the overarching idea of probability when it comes to A-levels, right? Is that you're going to be looking at one case whereby there are mutually exclusive events, and when they are not mutually exclusive, and when they're not mutually exclusive, then you have got independent and non-independent events that will be occurring. Okay, so let's first look at what mutually exclusive means. So the idea of mutually exclusive events. Alright, so mutually exclusive events, okay, occurs basically when, or what this actually means is when both events cannot happen at the same time. Alright, so as the word implies, okay, mutually exclusive, okay, they are both completely exclusive events, which means that these two events do not intersect at all, okay? They do not coincide, they do not share any properties. So if you find your probability, when you have got A intersects B, you'll find that your probability will just be zero, okay, because there's no way they can actually intersect. So if you look at a Venn diagram, for those of you guys who remember what Venn diagram is, okay, for example, let's say we've got a box with all our elements inside. Okay, you've got basically event A and event B, right? They are not going to be intersecting, okay, they are completely mutually exclusive, right? So this is a new event that some of you guys may not have seen before, and it's something they need to know, right? In the event that they are actually mutually exclusive, right? Then the other case is when they are independent, okay, when they are not mutually exclusive, they can be independent or not independent. So if you're looking at the case whereby they are independent events, right, when they're independent events, what this basically means is that the occurrence of A does not affect the occurrence of B. Okay, what does this mean? All right, it basically, essentially, when these events are actually independent, it means that when one event does indeed happen, okay, they could be intersecting, no doubt, okay, but when the occurrence of one event is actually happening, for example, if A is occurring, the probability of A, okay, it would not actually affect the occurrence of B. Okay, so they are completely independent, but they are not mutually exclusive. I still need to kind of like differentiate what the two are. Okay, mutually exclusive basically means that they are completely not related, But when they're independent, it means that they are related, but they do not affect each other. Okay, they can still operate on their own. Okay, which means that yes, they can intersect. So your P can still intersect. Your probability of A intersecting B. Okay, would actually give you this formula. Okay, that you need to know. This one is a math formula that you need to understand. It's going to be probability of A multiplied by the probability of B. Alright, so this is basically the main formula that you need to know for the entire probability. It is when your probability of A intersects B, in the case of independent events, okay, is that your probability of A, which is a complete independent, okay, and it's on its own probability, will, when you take this and you multiply it by the probability of B occurring, you will get what their intersect is. Alright, so just be clear on this part. Alright, events that are mutually exclusive do not intersect at all. Events that are not mutually exclusive means that they intersect. But even if they intersect, to find the intersecting portion, if they are independent events, you need to take the probability of A, multiply it by the probability of B. Alright, so this is basically what this part on independent events and mutually exclusive events are all about. Alright, so when it comes to your probability for this A-level syllabus, okay, you're going to be looking at several tools that you may want to use. So the several tools that you'll have to use and you need to know, okay, would be firstly, tree diagrams. So this one is, without a doubt, okay, tree diagrams basically is the one that you split the probability. So let's say the event of A and B. Okay, this probability over here, this box plus this circle, would add up to a probability of 1. Okay, so for example, 0.7. This will have to be 0.3, okay, the probability of each happening. So this one, the question will have to give. Then from A, then it may split again to further events of C, D, E, and F. And the probability of this and probability of this will add up to become 1 as well. So 0.6, 0.4, and this over here and this will have different probabilities, right? So this is how a tree diagram is. You may need to use it. Okay, it really depends on the context of the question. So another one you may have to use would be your Venn diagram, right? Definitely. Okay, Venn diagrams are very, very common, okay, when it comes to probability. So Venn diagrams, you just need to look at in the case whereby if there is a union, okay, when there's a union or intersection of two events. So for example, when your probability of A union B, this can be 1. Your probability when A intersects B, when P A intersects B complement. So always remember all your complements, right? A in complement intersect B. So these are all possibilities. K, P of A intersect B complement, both complement. Okay, so go and look at all these cases. Okay, I will look at some formulas later as to how you can find all these. Okay, another way that they can ask you to use probability, a tool, okay, would be through your P and C. So we've already gone through in the previous part. So this one involves things like when there are combinations, when there are permutations, and you need to count. Okay, we need to count certain events, then you have to use P and C. It's also a question, based on the question, okay, usually they would already involve some P and C in there. So it could be something, for instance, 3 choose 2 over 5 choose 7, something like this. Okay, this could be how like a probability looks like for P and C. Okay, probability is always going to be a fraction that is not more than 1. Another way is could be through your listing or table form. Okay, you have to basically create a table, okay, and then find what certain parts, okay, actually multiply. Alright, so this one is a very, they're all basically very context-driven, okay, really based on what the question gives you, right? So, if you look at certain formulas that you may want to use, oh, sorry if you're not able to see that. Okay, if you want to look at certain formulas that you want to use in probability, okay, I'm going to list out some formulas over here. I reckon you just jot it down, okay? I don't have examples here, okay, because like I've said, it is really based on the question. So, I will go through all these in my stats questions that I will be doing, and I've already done some. Okay, so these are basically the main formulas that you just need to make sure you have it as like a cheat list, okay, next to your paper. Okay, I mean, of course you cannot bring this into the exam, but you should have it in your head, okay, so that when you go into the paper, you know that, okay, this formula I can use to actually find what my probability is going to be. Okay, so the first formula would be when your the probability of an A union B. Okay, this is basically the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A intersect B. Alright, the probability when A union B will also be when probability of A and probability of B are added. Okay, so over here you have got two formulas that find the exact same probability, but why is it so that one of them you have to minus the probability of A intersect B. Alright, so this brings us back to just now, okay, initially when I was talking about your independent and mutually exclusive events. So when the events are mutually exclusive, you would want to use this formula over here. When the events are not mutually exclusive, okay, which means that they intersect, okay, and you want to find what the probability of A union B is, but if they are independent events, then you have to use this first formula over here. Alright, reason being is because, like we have said, if they are independent events, the occurrence of A occurring does not affect the occurrence of B, which means that from all this, you still have to make sure that you minus their intersect. So this is just a basic concept that you need to know, okay, when they are mutually exclusive, you just need to add up very simply what the probability of A is plus the probability of B. Okay, but if they are independent events and they are not mutually exclusive, you have to make sure that you get rid of the probability of A intersecting B. Alright, so just take note of this formula, okay, it's a bit tricky. Alright, the probability of A complement, as you guys should know, will be 1 minus the probability of A. Alright, A complement is basically anything that is outside and not inclusive of A. The probability when A union B can also be 1 minus the probability of A complement intersecting B complement. Alright, so this could be one of them as well. And lastly, K would be in the case when your P A union B can also simply be the probability of A intersecting B complement plus the probability of B, right? So these are all kind of like just mixing around, okay? You're just mixing the values around to find what the probability will be, okay? So you can just go ahead and play with different formulas, right? This is all flexible, okay? These are just some examples I'm giving you. So it really depends on the question, and then from there you will fit, okay, the different formulas in, okay? So this usually pertains to your Venn diagram based questions. Alright, then after that, the next concept you need to know for A-levels would be this thing called the conditional probability. I've already gone through this question. Oh no, I think I may not have gone through it yet. Okay, I'll be going through this question soon, okay, in our A-level papers. So not to worry. But conditional probability, okay, the key definition is that if A and event B are any two events of a sample space or a sample S, and that the probability of B is not equivalent to zero, then the conditional probability of event A, given that event B has occurred, is given by this formula. So the formula is the probability of A with this line, this is a conditional, this means given that B is equivalent to P of A intersect B over the probability of B. Alright, so this is a very classic conditional probability based example, whereby every time the question gives you this phrase, given that something occurs, given that event something, given that something, you always have to use conditional probability. So this line over here, okay, indicates A, and this line means given B. Right, so the probability of A occurring given that B has occurred would be given by their intersect over here, A intersect B, over the probability of the event that has occurred. In this case, it is event B. Right, so this is the formula that you need to know for your conditional probability. Right, but in the case that if they are independent events, then what happens? Like we have said before, right? Okay, the occurrence of A does not affect the occurrence of B, which means that the conditional probability would not stand or would not hold. Okay, which means that if they're independent events, what happens is that the probability of A given B, okay, let's see if that's what the question gives, would just very simply be the probability of A. Okay, because we cannot even have a case whereby it is given that B has occurred, because if they are independent events, they occur independently. One event A, does not affect the occurrence or the probability of event B happening. So in this case, if the probability, they're asking to find the probability of A given that B has occurred, the answer would very simply be that they are independent. Hence, you can only find from P A given that B would be just probability of A. Likewise, if they're asking you, okay, find the probability that B, find the probability of B given that A has occurred, your answer would just very simply be the probability of B, since there is no way that the event A can occur alongside B, right? Because they are independent events, right? So just need to know, okay, that this is the other part, okay, of conditional probability that you have to be very careful. Look at the wordings of the question to figure out, okay, what exactly the question is asking and what is required of you. All right, so if not, that actually is all for your entire probability syllabus. Is quite simple, I would say. Okay, the only reason why this video for a few of you may still be a bit messy or a bit, you may still be a bit unsure on what probability is because I don't actually have any examples here to show you how we can put all this into play. All right, so moving forward, okay, when I've got more statistics videos from your past A-level papers coming out, okay, you would see, okay, how we are going to be using Venn diagrams, tree diagrams, conditional probability, again, when mutually exclusive and independent events when it comes to answering questions, okay, so that you're able to properly understand, okay, how exactly probability should be done. All right, so don't worry if this video, you're still a bit unsure at the end of this video, okay, it is perfectly normal, okay, but I reckon that you just take down some notes from this video, okay, and make sure that you understand, okay, what is required for you, at least the basics, okay, of understanding what a mutually exclusive event is, understanding what an independent event is, understanding what conditional probability is all about. Okay, and then when it comes to the questions, we will make sure that it becomes extremely easy for you to do as well. Right, so that's all I have for this video. Okay, if you did enjoy this video, okay, be sure to give it a like as well as to subscribe. It doesn't cost you anything, it's free, and it really does help me out a lot as well. All right, if you have any questions, you can always leave in the comment section below. I will answer them as soon as possible. If not, if you guys want to know another part, or at least need help, okay, in another math topic, okay, and you want the basic content series for that, okay, do let me know in the comment section and I will create a video on that as well. Alright, so if not, that is all I have. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.